September 25th, 2019. The Intrepid Duo departs the warm climes of the Pacific Northwest for the frigid Northern Rockies. There's my beautiful Kia. I bought it for $200. I named it the Millennium Falcon because that's what it sounds like when you shift. But it's actually been a really good vehicle. And yeah, well, I'm gonna miss you, baby. Got my buddy Alabama, who is a familiar hobo legend that some of you may know, be aware of. And we are heading for a location at the train tracks to catch a train to Montana. Hey, Alabama! Where are we?
Portland Light Rail Station.
What are we doing here?
We're gonna hop on this train.
Where are we going?
I think downtown. Then we're gonna go to Montana.
Montana?
I hope so.
It sounds cold.
It does sound very cold. I brought thermals.
Well, I hope you have a plan. Alabama, what are we gonna do when we get to Montana?
Oh, we're gonna go to the Isaac Walton and we're gonna eat a really nice dinner.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. And hopefully use their facilities again to maybe wash my clothes and or bathe and charge my phone again and really.
Yeah.
I hope they have another house under construction that we can stay in.
So the Isaac Walton Hotel is a hotel in northern Montana on the border of Glacier National Park. And it also happens to be right on the Burlington Northern Santa Fe main line, the ex-Great Northern. And yeah, it's a popular rail fan destination, but little do they know at the Isaac Walton that it's about to be a popular train rider destination. But anyway, we'll talk more about the history of that and who Isaac Walton was.
Oh, no, it is. It's the old hotel built to bring people out west to see and invest.
There.
A place to lodge and a place to see what there is to offer out in that area.
Do you remember when it was built?
I do not remember when it was built, but
it's old.
But they did pre-plan it out on the floor.
Okay, we're up here by the spot, and one train just came through. It very possibly could have been our train, probably, but we weren't entirely in position yet. Anyway, well, here comes the BNSF van. We're just laying low now. Okay, we have a train, and we're gonna try to board it. Okay, well, I'm pretty irritated right now. We ran over there and started to board the train and climb on right as it was pulling out on the fly. And somehow there was a vehicle, a work vehicle, or a crew vehicle, I'm not sure which, parked immediately on the other side of the train from where we tried to get on. And as soon as I climbed up on top of the porch area to get on the car, we went right by him. And I didn't feel comfortable trying to ride on, having been seen like that. I don't know. sailing the Bathyscope. We're on the move.
I only brought one beer for the train all the way to Montana. But I made it count. This one's called Comatose. 8.5% alcohol.
Weehaw! All alone and lost, for a life of sin, I have paid the cost. When I pass by, all the people say, just another guy on the lost highway. I was just a lad, nearly 22. Neither good nor bad, just a kid like you. And now I'm lost, too late to pray. Lord, I paid the cost on the lost highway. Don't start to running around on this road of sin. Or your sorrow back. Take my advice, or you'll curse the day.
Down. Coming that into the Spokane area now.
what's going on right now.